Hey, this is Jeremy from Unito. Today I'm going to show you how you can use Unito to create a two-way sync between Salesforce and Smartsheet. Already I've got Salesforce open in front of me. I'm in the leads page, but you can sync any contacts, opportunities, or basically any object inside of Salesforce using Unito. What I'll show you here is I've already created a few contacts, some that have synced inside of Smartsheet and others that haven't. I've set up a rule inside of Unito so that only the leads with that are being worked currently are actually being synced over. And so if you look for this last name for Abby Gao, you'll see that it's not in Smartsheet just yet on my right-hand side. So what I'll do now is I'll actually change that lead status over from open, not contacted to working contacted as my sales rep starts to work on it. And you can imagine a workflow where based on whether a rep is working or maybe has finished working, a spreadsheet is updated, and that information is being used for a nurture campaign or reactivation or anything like that. But it's super useful to have this pop up inside of Smartsheet. So I'm going to give this a refresh, and we should see that appear shortly. So I can see now this Acme, company has appeared, and it's got all the same information as I had inside of Salesforce. It's got my name, the email, the contacted date, the lead status, the state, etc., that I can sync over. And now, what's super powerful about something like Unito is that if I also now update something over on the Smartsheet side, like adding a phone number, so let's do 303 303 3300, I'm going to save that over on the Smartsheet side. And what's great is that Unito is going to notice that this change has happened and actually bring that back over into the Salesforce side. So now let's see what happens behind the scenes in order to get something like this set up. So I'm now inside of Unito, and I already have a number of flows set up. Let me just show you how you can use Unito to create a new flow between essentially Salesforce and Smartsheet. One of the things that you'll notice is that if I'm creating a new flow, is that I have the ability to, as I mentioned, select any object, accounts, cases, contacts, campaigns, to fit whatever workflow you need, from reporting on opportunities or deals to campaign management. Now I'm going to go back over to my existing Unito flow here, since I already have something that I've set up. And in this lead record, Salesforce leads row workflow, we're going to be able to see sort of what's happening behind the scenes. So once you select the projects and the kind of object that you want to sync between these two tools, you have to select the flow direction. This determines basically where items are going to be created. In the case of Salesforce, one thing to note is that although we can create objects from Salesforce into Smartsheet, we can't pull Smartsheet objects and use them to create Salesforce contacts. And so there are some limitations there that you need to be aware of. Once you select the flow direction, we can also set up the rules. These rules are what I described earlier, which determined which contacts or leads, in this case, inside of Salesforce, were actually being brought into Smartsheet. In my case, I wanted to make sure that only the leads with the status working, contacted, closed, not converted, or closed converted, basically any lead that had been actioned on by my rep, was actually being brought into Smartsheet. So you can use a combination of these rules, any of the fields from either Salesforce or Smartsheet in order to create this setup and this trigger. And then the last step is the field mapping. The field mapping is how you're going to determine what fields inside of Salesforce appear over in Smartsheet. And so things like their email address, phone number, all of that can be either automatically mapped, or we can create custom mappings if we have, for example, columns that don't quite line up in terms of names. So you see here I had status over on the Salesforce side, which I wanted to map to my lead status field in Smartsheet. And in those cases, you can just select the mapping, and then select sort of what is going to be mapped over on the other side. And Unito will carry that information over. It can also do drop downs if you need that. So there's a lot of sort of flexibility there depending on what your workflow looks like. And that's it. Once you've set everything up, you can also find a lot more information about how the flow's been going below in the recent activity, or create more workflows with other tools, sync calendar, sync other CRMs, and a lot more. So if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us over at unito.io. Thank you very much.